In this video, we're going to be talking about motivation in language learning. Hi, I'm Mark from Coffee Break Languages, and I'm having my coffee break this morning with you. Today we're talking about motivation. We hear about motivation all the time, whether it's about motivational speakers we're listening to or Monday motivation images on Instagram we're looking at. And sometimes it feels like we're supposed to be motivated all the time, especially when it comes to language learning. Motivation is defined as what explains why people or animals initiate, continue, or terminate a certain behaviour at a particular time. It's the reason behind the decisions we make. And we make so many decisions every day. We choose to have an ice cream to cool down in the middle of a heat wave. We choose to walk to work rather than drive in order to take a step towards a more healthy lifestyle. And we choose to learn a language for so many reasons. Perhaps there's some kind of extrinsic motivation involved in your reason for learning a language by reaching a certain level. Perhaps you're in line for a promotion, or maybe you're working towards passing an exam, which will open up a particular door for you. On the other hand, maybe your motivation is intrinsic. Perhaps you've chosen to learn the language simply because you enjoy discovering new things, or because it's great fun. Personally, I don't think motivation is a definitive stationary concept. It can often change, and one type of motivation can result in another. If I think back to when I started learning French in my first year of secondary school, my motivation was to do well and pass my exams and keep my parents happy. But over time, I realised how much I enjoyed learning the language, and I quickly pushed myself further simply because it brought me pleasure, because I enjoyed it. The other aspect of motivation which changes constantly is the amount of motivation we have for a particular activity, like language learning. What is it that makes you think, no, I am not going to watch another episode of whichever Netflix show I'm currently obsessed with? Instead, I am going to spend the next 30 minutes on my French adjective agreements or my Italian subjunctive instead. It's almost like reaching a crossroads and making the decision to turn left towards Netflix or turn right towards your language learning, and taking the next step in building your vocabulary that bit more, or finally understanding the preceding direct object rule. Of course, sometimes our motivation seems to pack its bags and head off for a fortnight in the sun on a beach in the Mediterranean, leaving us struggling to get back into our good language learning routines. At times like this, it's really difficult to take the right turn, and I think that as language learners, we often treat this as a setback. We're hard on ourselves because we feel that we're not moving forward. But here's the thing. I believe that sometimes the right language learning decision is actually to watch the Netflix show, to read the book, to go out for a walk, or do whatever it is that doesn't feel like language learning. Now, that may seem a little bit counterproductive, counterintuitive. But working against the tide and trying desperately to find that motivation when it's off enjoying itself without us can end up pushing us further away from our end goal. The fact is, sometimes it's actually in that change of scenery that we rediscover the motivation we thought we'd lost. I'm sure this has happened to you. Perhaps you've chosen to read a book, but there's suddenly a new character introduced in chapter 3 who is a Swedish speaker, and she mentions the town of Örebro, which you've recently heard about in your Swedish lessons. Or perhaps you're watching a film and you suddenly find yourself thinking about a phrase used in the script and wondering how you translate that into French. Maybe you've gone out for some fresh air and you happen to walk past a family who are speaking Italian and you realise that you can understand some of what they're saying. Before you know it, your mind starts to think about your language learning and you're back on track. So my message to you is that you shouldn't worry too much if you find yourself losing some of that motivation for learning. If this happens, try not to force yourself back into the language and generate some kind of false enthusiasm. There's nothing worse because it doesn't last. Instead, give it some time, give yourself some space, do something different, and the chances are you'll discover that your motivation is simply waiting for you patiently in the least likely place. I'd love to hear what you think. What is your motivation for learning the language? Has this changed over time? Have you lost and found your motivation at any point? Do you have any ideas as to what would help you get back your motivation after losing it? Let me know what you think in the comments. In the meantime, thanks for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, make sure you like it. And while you're here, I'd love you to subscribe to our Coffee Break Languages channel to get more help with your language learning. Of course, as ever, happy coffee breaking and happy language learning. And who knows, perhaps this video was exactly the motivation you needed to get back into your language.